Hi, my name is Tim, and in this video I would like to show you how I made this grip for my compound bow. As you can see, it's not the default grip that used to be on there. It's a different grip that I made myself, and in this video I want to show you how I made it, and I will also discuss in a bit more detail why I made this grip. To make my grip, I used a large piece of wooden beam. And I had to cut out a piece of the end because that had a lot of holes in it, and I basically couldn't use that part. So I used the middle piece of the wood, and what I did, I outlined my recurve grip, because this grip is for my compound bow. But my recurve bow has a grip that I really, really like. And I know that there is a difference between a compound bow grip and a recurve bow grip. But that was actually something I wanted to experiment, also for my website, to see what is actually the difference between a compound bow grip and a recurve grip. Why is there such a huge difference? Why is a recurve grip more thick than a compound grip, and why is a recurve grip more angled? So I wanted to test it out. And what you can see right here is actually the most difficult part of making the entire grip. That was making the slot the correct size and the correct orientation. That was actually quite difficult, because it isn't something you can measure, and you really had to do it on feel and trial and error. In the end, when I was done with the grip, it had a tiny bit of wobble, but when I screwed the screws in, the wobble was almost completely gone, and it felt really nice in my hand. So I am not too concerned that the slight wobble will be an issue. But this was the hardest part of making the grip. That's also why I wanted to start with making the slot as early as possible, because I wasn't sure whether that would work out correctly. And now you see that I am finalizing the slot, because it was still not fitting correctly on my compound bow. What the next step was making the grip to my hand, because now it's really, really square. And I had to round it off, and that was actually a lot more fun. Just rounding off the edges and making sure that it fits correctly to my hand. And it was also quite a fast process. But what I did was I tried it a lot. I put it in my hand, simulating a bow, but I also shot my bow a few times. You will see that in the next few clips. And that was actually really useful, because I noticed that I still had some nasty pressure points on my thumb, or near my thumb. So in the end, I was really, really happy with how the grip turned out. It was it felt great in my hand, and it was overall very, very nice. And as you can see, what I did was I finished it off with some sandpaper to make it really smooth, and applied some clear lacquer to make sure that it is watertight and it will last a long time. Here is some close-up footage of the grip, and as you can see, what I did is I almost completely removed this upper lip, and that is to make sure that my hand fits nicely on it, and that my bone doesn't rub against that upper lip, because that was actually what caused much of my issues, because that was really, really painful. And now it fits perfectly in my hand, and it feels really, really nice to shoot. Thank you for watching, and please leave a like if you liked this video, and also leave a comment on any other suggestions you would like to add, and I'll see you in the next video.